collaborating in general, like Danny, like do all of your guys co-produce or what's their vibe on it? Like, do they like working with writers, or what's, you know, outside of the direct artist connection, what are some things your guys do to keep moving and get their name out there?
Yeah. Well, I mean, a strategy that I think a lot of European producers and producers all over the world, but what I find, especially with a lot of European producers, is they're sending out loops and they're accepting loops in. And when you collab on beats, you know, well, let's say me and you are producers, you know, I'm going to be shopping the beat, you're going to be shopping the beat, your manager is going to be shopping the beat, my manager is going to be shopping the beat. So you now have four different people trying to place a record. And not only that, you're learning and you're practicing new music, and yep. you're really kind of perfecting the craft. So I think it's super important to collab. All my producers are super open to collabing with any producer. It doesn't matter if they have a big name, they just like dope music. And yeah, a huge focus this year and the last few months has been connecting directly with songwriters and sending demos out and getting hooks. Super important. I mean, standing out, because everyone's sending beat packs. And it's a great skill to be able to get an acapella and put a beat on it. That's super important to be able to do in production. And also being easy to work with. Like, in the music industry, if people don't like working with you, you're going to have a hard time having a career, you know? So it's a great skill to really work on. And working with songwriters is super, super important, for sure. And I mean, absolutely. For you, I'm sure you're always trying to get your roster, working with other people outside of the Sony TV family and just expanding their network, work and name, really.
Absolutely. I mean, thinking about, like, a big question that's come up on here and other places is, like, what's the X factor for a producer? And obviously quality of production and instrumentation and musical prowess is leads the way always. Like, the sounds you're making is always the first thing you got to worry about. But what comes right behind that is the ability to network, the ability to be professional, which I think isn't talked about enough, because, you know, we're in a space where, you know, a lot about is how you vibe with each other, but taking that into a place where, you know, you're turning stuff around together, you're getting notes, yeah. And, you know, collaborating and compromising. Like, if all art is about decision making, I mean, when you bring somebody else into your process like that, like, the best collaborations are the results of some, like, strongly willed people that bring in some compromises. So aside from, you know, everything you're doing musically, networking and professionalism, I think are super important in collaborations. And that's what some of the best are doing. So I think it's great to see, like, how BeatStars has evolved over time to allow collaborations to be easy on collab beats. Like, you know, when you're selling in the marketplace, like, you know, divide that fee into two. I think that's great. Outside the marketplace, you know, like, make sure these people, like, you know, are your friends, and they become your constant collaborators, because you never know what it could lead to.